Hello, and welcome to technically episode 3, but in a way episode 1 of Roar, Roads of Apocalyptic Rage, from the Depths tournament. So, between the second round and this round, I decided, for fairness sake, to go in and change the AI and settings for pathing on all of the vehicles in the tournament, so hopefully we'll get less ring outs, just to have more interesting fights. And so the first two battles will be re-recorded at the end of all of the other fights. So the score results right now will be overwritten, but we'll need to wait for that. So, right now we've got 3Dwrecker's hopefully new and improved AI team against the team by Jeoshy with the spawn order. I think I've got the laser lizards on the right side, but I'm not entirely sure that's how he wants it, but in the spawn order that was specified. So yeah, let's just go ahead and actually I need to set the music. Yes, and there we go. Okay. Get the battle started. So we've got those laser lizards scuttling in, and scuttling in fast. Some missiles are away. Now then, these things getting close is horrifying. Oh yeah, and they do have shield on the front. Oh, one of the nukes went off. And that's the price that the fanatics pay. Where can this one get turned around in time? Okay, well, it seems like the pathing is working better. It's actually, turning the vehicle around. And, here we get to see the scything tail coming in. I'm just going to work on the hauler. Oh, and it just completely takes out, well, okay, I guess it's still like completely takes out the weapon on one of the outriders. Oh goodness, you're trying, but you've also exposed your nuke side. Got your tail stuck. Oh no, tail fell off. That's okay. It's still up the front. But let's see how things are doing elsewhere. So we got one of the typical turtles coming. Getting peppered with heat. Missiles are out, missiles are away, and those are direct hits. Of course, the full layering of heavy armor on the outside really protect them against those HE blasts. So two of the outrunners have been taken out. I'm willing to bet at least one of those was the one that was hit by the exciting tale of the laser lizard, because the vehicles do have a 20-second sustain. Oh, that was another nuke. Oh, and just the heat spam has worked without the outrunners diving off the edge. It seems like the force is a lot more effective. In spite of the low heat penetration metric, they are getting in there. Of course, the hauler still alive, but boy, is it taking some blows. And it's doing its job of healing up the outrunners that sort of drive by, getting their pit stop in. And we've just got one tickle turtle on the other side that see some of those huge tracer shells. Well, huge tracers on the shells. Bullets look a lot bigger than they actually are. And the tanky stolen hollow. I mean, yeah. Jeoshy's team just came right in and drove off with it while it was unattended. Should have had a security detail on it, I guess. But this thing is fairly heat-proof. I made sure to do that. So the hauler might survive. Still at 99%, plus it's got heals, so I don't think the heat's actually going to get through. Oh, missile hit on the outrunner. Not enough few blocks. Although 3Dwrecker's team is winning, at the end there is a, I believe it's a three-point lead for aesthetics going to Jeoshy's team. Tickle Turtle now getting hit. Looks like it managed to do some... Oh yeah, it took out the weaponry there. Holding its own up here on the ridge. At least momentarily. Making its last stand, kind of gotten itself stuck, but missile hits. It does seem to be focusing on the closest opponents, which is serving it well. To actually hit the things that are coming up on the ridge. I believe okay. I heard an engine popping. I No, we just had an outrunner just die. Seems like this tickle turtle is tickling 3Dwrecker's fancy here. We've got a one-man wrecking crew here in this outstanding gunner. Sniper's Ridge up here. And this one tickle turtle is single-handedly turning this match around. We may have an upset. Nasty hits. It very much depends on whether the tipping turtle goes down or not. And that took the turret out. Tickle Turtle is single-handedly turning the match around. Another turret falls. And another one's gone. Another one's gone. Another one bites the dust. This time, I'm very, very glad that I changed the AI settings for the teams now. I'm able to bring you some exciting footage like this. Much appreciation for the suggestion. I think it was actually Jeoshy who suggested the change. Thank you very much. Oh, wow. What an upset, what a turnaround. I think the missiles are going to be able to come back around. Maybe they will. They might have enough life in them. Oh, that was a long-lasting missile. Managed to get back around and get in there. Oh, goodness. Okay. Mutant Ninja Turtle here fighting off all the foot soldiers. Never a dull moment with this turtle. Of course, 3Dwrecker's team is sort of making it easy for the turtle coming in. Seems to be one by one and getting picked off. They're definitely pulling a martial arts movie where you've got the big crowd surrounding the good guy and just like one or two of them attack at a time, rather than all coming in and ganging up on them. Thank you. these missiles are going the distance. They're going for the hauler. Will they make it? If they do... Oh, wow, okay. That means that Jeoshy's team has a chance for a complete victory here. Oh yeah, that runner's just died, the one that we just passed over. And having no trouble hitting from this range, well, of course I would say that, I'd see a few misses, but it seems like the accuracy is enough to land blows without too much trouble. Well, again, I say that, and... You know, 50% of shots, perhaps? Okay, so it's the timed frag blasts that are managing to hit. They've got timed fuses on them, so... Get a good camera position here. Good missile hits. Of course, all of that heavy armor is keeping the HP up for the time being. Because the frag's not going to do too much against heavy armor. Though it eventually will chew through it, eventually. Down to 60%. Well, yeah, the trade-off for turning like this, you get the exciting moments like we saw earlier with the Tickle Turtle 1v9ing or something like that, 1v8ing the opposing team. And then you've got moments like this where you have to wait like a number of minutes while the health is just slowly being whittled away. But yes, I can officially call it that Jeoshy's team has won this fight, although a much better performance this time from 3Dwrecker's side, much better showing. Proving that they have shown up to fight. Seems like 3Dwrecker has employed some new motivational techniques for the drivers. I wonder if it's like, fight to the death, get free beer. Or fight to the death and get to something about thinking Mad Max, but nah, that's too much. Yeah. Down to 51%. Of course, the sustainment for the vehicles is at 40% health. So it's still got a ways to go, but there's no fighting back. I don't think there's any healing from this. The damage is too slow. About 1% more shaved off. We've just got 1.5 minutes left. Will this manage to take out the hauler before the time limit? That is the question currently. Does not make much of a difference to Jeoshy's team, but in the long run it may make a difference to 3Dwreckers. As the tournament winner is dependent upon remaining health over the course of all the battles. And I think it may survive this, unless it gets AI deaded. I have no commenter's curse. It's not to Menti levels. Oh. And that's time. So the hauler actually does survive and may make a difference in the long run. It remains to be seen. But congratulations to Jeoshy. Remaining score, let's see, the hauler has survived, and there's also, as I say, a +3 to aesthetic score, so 47.1 to, well, 9.5. Okay, and until the next fight, as always, enjoy.